morning from southeast Iowa. It's November 2nd. The calendar has turned to our favorite month of the year. We're all in this morning. We're in the heart of the farm, right in the middle of the cover. It's supposed to be higher pressure today. Nice cool morning, frost everywhere. The sun is just coming up. We're 20 feet closer to God this morning. There's no doubt about that.
So we're sitting there, it's about 9 o'clock, and I could see these two does come up out of the creek bottom. They're kind of working their way up, but it looked like something was bumping them. I'm looking, it's like maybe, I don't know, 100 yards through the timber. It's kind of open, but there's some snags and some fallen trees. And then I could just, there I saw his strange right side, and I knew right away it was E.T. They were kind of working their way up the hill, not towards us. And so I react. I didn't even think about it. I just immediately. I didn't know if he heard it or not, because it seemed to be a lot of commotion where they were. Plus, they were pretty far away.
He's coming. See that big down log? There he is.
So I knew he heard that. He stopped. He was looking, but he didn't come right in.
See him. Here he comes.
So I snort wheezed at him. I threw a really hard. This deer's coming in. You know there's a most likely you're going to get a crack at him. So now you're starting to go through these different. Okay, is that my hole? That I'm ranging some different holes depending on what angle he's going in. So I range this one hole and I tell myself.
32.
And it's really kind of open in front of us, and so I draw early. Maybe I'll have to hold for 20 seconds or so. He's gonna be in my wheelhouse immediately. And then he just stops. I'm saying, okay, let's calm down. He's gonna be right in a perfect opening, 18 yards away, right to my left here. So just hold. Just hold. He's just at a standstill. Looking back, me calling right at him, he knew right where I was. And he came right there. He got behind a tree. I could see his liver and back. There's no way I'm shooting that deer in his liver. I'm waiting for a vital shot in his lungs or his heart, or no shot at all. Problem is, that smart old buck didn't move a muscle, and he waited me out. And I held draw for, I think, Micah ended up telling me a minute and 30 or 40 seconds. I draw back again, get the bow back. He's in the hole. Yeah. Just under him. Startles him a little bit, looks back. He didn't know what it was. He didn't smell us, but he didn't like it. And probably chalked it off as just a limb falling or something, non-threat. So that was a good thing, but you know, in reality, he was 42 yards away when I ranged it again and not 32. I should have been more in the moment to say, hey, stop. He's a little bit further. Aim a little higher, choose a different pin. But 32 was burned into me, and that's what I shot at. Clean miss. Really glad I didn't wound him, because I knew that there was going to possibly be another chance to have at him. Obviously, I was bummed. I was down. Man, that was my opportunity. But I'm thinking, you know what? I just avoided a huge, huge headache wounding this deer. When you wound an animal or just put a questionable shot on him, man, it can just wreck. It can wreck your day. It can wreck the next 3 days. It can wreck your season. It can put a lot of doubt in you. You have to put a lot of time into looking for that deer. You feel terrible for injuring him and possibly suffering, or who knows what can happen when you put a bad shot on a deer. Just overall, it sucks. And so I was really glad it was a clean miss. You know what? We're gonna go after him for another round. Seems like a lot of times I get on the phone with my clients and they're asking me what seasons I prefer to hunt. Obviously, bow season's my top, but for gun season, we have the choice between early muzzleloader, shotgun one, shotgun two, or late season muzzleloader. And without question, late season muzzleloader is my favorite time to gun hunt. So this first couple hunts were to break in the muzzleloader. I was gonna shoot some does, get some reconnaissance. I was gonna stay away from that one plot that I thought that ET was gonna come out on. I still wanted to get some recon. Oh my gosh, look at that. Started to get some chip away at that management plan, the doe quota, knocked the rust off the McWhorter. Was able to shoot one at 220 and one at 250. Can reach out really far and smash these deer. Now the excitement is starting to build because we're seeing deer, and I look in the forecast and here comes a big snowstorm that's gonna hit southeast Iowa. So it's 4:30, it's starting to get dark. It's already overcast and we're losing light fast. I can see ET far away and he's kind of working his way down the creek and it looks like he's gonna come into the plot. Problem is he's really too far to get a good solid close view with the lens that we're shooting with, and so he's got to cover a lot of distance. I'm thinking, now what are we gonna do? We're gonna have our target buck in the field. How are we gonna get out of here if I can't get a shot at him? All these things. We're saying, man, we got probably about a half hour left. About 20 minutes goes by, and that's a long 20 minutes because you only get so many opportunities to lay your eyes on a target buck. Many times, it doesn't happen in the season. Sometimes it happens once. Sometimes you have multiple encounters with them. You play cat and mouse, but here, this is our chance. Legendary whitetail, ET. Oh, what a cool buck, man. Super mature deer. Probably the oldest buck on the farm that we know of. Ancient buck.